Hey guys, what's going on? This is Jacob here playing some Stardew Valley. So this is a new Let's Play that I'm going to be starting. Now, I understand that this is not exactly like a new game, but I'm kind of taking a different approach than a lot of people are taking on YouTube right now, where everybody's just playing all of these newer games and almost kind of like doing the whole clickbait thing, where they're just trying to get people to watch their videos because they're the only people posting the videos of that content at the moment. So I'm trying to play some of the older games. This is going to be aimed more towards like the people who have played the game themselves, maybe didn't have as much success as they wanted to on it. So yeah, you can see that I had 10 million gold on my first playthrough. But yeah. We'll go ahead and get in here, kind of show you what this game is about. So let's see, for my name, I will just do Jacob. Farm name, at Jacob's farm. Oh, it already gives me farm. Yeah, very original. Favorite thing. Doge. I want the Doge. I want him bod. I'm a ghost, so I'm gonna do this. Oh, yes. Then, gotta have those purple eyes. It's not very purple, let's see. Whatever. Hair color, let's see. Oh my goodness. Yes. The purple. Gotta go all purple. Why can't I choose my shirt color? I guess I just have to change the shirt entirely. Oh, yes. Punk rock. Right there. And for my farm, just so this is easier, I'm gonna just do the standard farm. It's just regular, it's not weird. You know what? No. I don't know. I almost want to try the forest farm. No, let's do the standard farm. I know what I'm doing on that one. So yeah, I'm not skipping the intro. I want you guys to be able to see the intro, just because I specifically think that the intro for this game is good for what this game is. So I'm gonna go ahead and stop talking and let y'all watch this. Thank you. All right, so I'm going to click on that and it says, "Dear Jacob, if you're reading this, you must be in dire need of a change." Oh, how this relates to real life. The same thing happened to me long ago. I'd lost sight of what mattered most in life, real connections with other people and nature. So I dropped everything and I moved to the place I truly belonged. I've enclosed the deed to that place, my pride and joy, Jacob's Farm. It's located in Stardew Valley on the southern coast. It's the perfect place to start your new life. This was my most precious gift of all, and now it's yours. I know you'll honor the family name, my boy. Good luck. Love, Grandpa. P.S. If Lewis is still alive, say hi to the old guy for me, will ya? So, basically, what just happened in the intro is, your guy basically said, "Fuck this job. I hate my life. I need a change." So he opened the letter that his grandpa told him to, and now he's gonna go to this farm, and you're gonna start a new life with some new peeps, and you're gonna not really have a job. You're not gonna do any of that stuff. You're just gonna farm. You're gonna create your own life, and it's actually very interesting, the whole game. There's just it's like there's a lot to do and there's not a lot to do. "Hello, you must be Jacob." "Hi, Robin." "I'm Robin, the local carpenter. Mayor Lewis sent me here to fetch you and show you the way to your new home. He's there right now tidying things up for your arrival. The farm's right over here if you'll follow me." All right. Trying to keep the mouse off the screen because the mouse can get kind of annoying. "This is Jacob's farm." I know, it's mine. And it looks like crap. "What's the matter?" "Sure, it's a bit overgrown, but there's some good soil underneath that mess. With a little dedication, you'll have it cleaned up in no time." And here we are, your new home. And Mayor Lewis. Ah, the new farmer. "Get the fuck out of my house. How dare you?" Just kidding. "Welcome. I'm Lewis, mayor of the Pelican Town. You know, everyone's been asking about you. It's not every day that someone new moves in. It's quite a big deal." "So, you're moving into your grandfather's old cottage. It's a good house. Very, quote, rustic." "Rustic, that's one way to put it. Crusty might be a little more apt, though." "Rude! How dare you?" "Don't listen to her, Jacob. She's just trying to make you dissatisfied so that you buy one of her house upgrades. She's like, bah! How dare you reveal my dirty secret, you old man? Anyway, you must be tired from the long journey. You should get some rest. Tomorrow, you ought to explore the town a bit and introduce yourself. The townspeople would appreciate that." "I'd appreciate if both of y'all would get off my property." "Oh, I almost forgot. If you have anything to sell, just place it in this box. I'll come by during the night to collect it, 'cause I'm creepy." "Well, good luck." "Creepy old man coming to my property to take my stuff and sell it for me during the middle of the night." Right. So. Oh, what is this? May I has parsnip seeds. I forgot. At first, I didn't even think that they gave you like a chest. Like I thought it just popped in your inventory. You received 15 parsnip seeds. Here's a little something to get you started. Cool. So in this game, at the beginning of every day, you want to check your weather report, your fortune teller, and your living off the land. This gives you some details on what the day is going to be like. She says, "Good humor today. I think you'll have a little extra luck." So this is going to be a day where, like, if I had a fishing rod, I would want to go fishing. Or like maybe go to the cave. That would be like the day I would want to go cave spelunking. It's going to be clear and sunny. Living off the land. We're back again, blah blah blah. Chop wood and search for old forage to earn some cash while waiting on your first harvest. So right there, they just gave a tip on how to make money very early on in the game. So I'm going to leave this area, and I'm going to take this, and I'm going to start clearing out some of this nasty grass. Now, you have a hunger bar, or an energy bar down here, that shows like how full, not really full, but like how much energy you have. So energy runs out really fast on this game. In fact, some days you may not even make it past 10 o'clock in the morning because of how tired your person is. That's one of the reasons why you want to forage and collect like food items and stuff. Because the food will actually give you energy so you can continue going through the day. You don't want your guy getting so tired that he just passes out at 10 o'clock in the morning. That's just not, it's not a way you want to live. And I got some mixed seeds, probably nothing useful, but nevertheless. But during your first day, you definitely want to get some parsnip seeds planted. And like, there's no like way you must play this game. But, oh goodness, what was that? Something on my desk like vibrated horribly. Okay. So this is gonna be my little starting area right here. Oh, oops, okay. So that's 3 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's 15. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. And then I'm going to stand in the middle here and I'm going to go boop, 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 boop. And I'm going to do that for these ones. And me, just because I'm, you know, weird like that, I like to separate everything. So, like, I'm going to separate the like, wild seeds and stuff that I get, or, like, maybe some of the stuff that I go buy. I'm going to separate all that stuff out, so that way, like, it's just neat. I don't like a messy farm. And every now and then you can find like geodes and stuff, which the only way I can describe a geode for this game is like it's this stone that contains minerals that are valuable. And with trees, the trees actually fall over, and you have to pick up all the stuff, and then you actually have to dig up the stump to completely get rid of it. Obviously, the hatchet breaks trees, the pickaxe breaks stone, all that good stuff. So I'm about half energy right now. So now, if I recall, how do I do things? Okay, so skills, none of that yet. I don't need the map. Crafting. So I'm going to make a torch. No, I don't need a torch, do I? I mean, I can't really make anything right now. Yeah, I'm not going to worry about any of that stuff. Right now, I'm going to go into town, though. And I'm going to possibly buy some food. I don't know, like, I don't really have a lot of money, so it might almost be more worth to buy parsnip seeds. Also, check this thing as well, because this is important. This tells you, like, events and people. So, like, you know, you can make certain people happy and, like, maybe, you know, like, marry them or whatever, like that kind of stuff. Not really something I do, like the whole marriage crap, but let's see, I'm just trying to think of what would be a good thing to start. mean, parsnip seeds only take 4 days to mature. I'm gonna do 20 of those, leave me with 100. And I'm gonna see if I can buy anything with the other 100 monies I have. And I don't even know if this is open right now. Probably not. It's locked. Open 12 p.m. To 12 a.m. Oh, well, here, let me stand here for 5 seconds until you open. Cultivate and harvest a parsnip. I think I already did that. I need to introduce myself to people. Oh, now I can go in here. Hi, person. I would like food. Do you sell food here? Hello, I would like food. May I buy food? Ah, here we go. Oh, goodness. And coffee is, like, awesome on this game. Pizza is awesome on this game. Wow, I'm so poor. I'm gonna just buy parsnip seeds. That's, like, the only logical thing to do right now. And then I'll show you another thing that you can do on here as well. Get out my way. Oh, my goodness. These people, I wish you could just walk through them. Okay. I've got 25 more parsnips. You can also check these trash cans. Yeah, they're like, why are you digging in the trash? It's like, leave me be. Don't ask questions. I'm a hobo. You see how I'm dressed. So, you go on the beach, and every day, there's, oh, I have a full inventory. Well, in that case, I will drop this sap, because I don't need sap. Eat the sap? Okay, sure. Did it do anything? Oh. Oh, it made me sick. No, thank you. Please drop. Trash. Thank you. Let's see. I will go ahead and drop this stone. Pick that up. And just search, like, this whole area to find stuff, because you can sell all of this and make some moolah. Another thing, too. Those little spots like that, if I recall correctly, you hit them with the hoe or something. Maybe a pickaxe? No, definitely the hoe. Like, if they're wiggling, I think, is actually what it is. You can find stuff buried in them. And then over here is a bridge that if you can cross early in the game, you can get some really good stuff. So you need 300 pieces of wood. Let's see how much I have. I have 26. Very good. So, not gonna do that. Not yet, at least. I'm gonna see if the fisherman guy is down here. He is not. So now I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna plant the rest of these parsnip seeds. Oh, oops. Let's see. Ugh. Maneuvering through this area is difficult. Nothing in the trash. Nothing in the trash. Darn. So now, I'm gonna go up here really quick and see if there's anything I can harvest like this. And, of course, my inventory's full. I'm gonna get rid of all this fiber. Okay, trash. Give me that. Keep walking around, see if I can find anything of value. But yeah, fishing on this game is where it's at for, like, money. Like, fishing is such a great way to get money on this game. Alright, so there's nothing immediate that I can collect. So I'm going to go back to the farm. I'm going to plant all of those parsnip seeds. And after I plant all the parsnip seeds, I'm going to go ahead and probably just clear out the rest of my farm as far as I can, of course, before I run out of energy and just pass out right where I'm standing. Another thing that you can do, too, early in the game is if you have no money, like zero money at all, don't even go to sleep because, like, you'll get carried to, like, the doctor in the game or something of that nature. And he'll bill you for a percentage or a fraction or whatever of the money you have in your inventory. Well, here's the thing. If you've got no money for him to bill you, well, how is he going to bill you? Like, you have no money. Like, so that's kind of an early game strat, I think. That may not be true, but I'll probably end up doing that tonight and just kind of seeing what happens. Perfect. And I've got clay. Now I'm going to put this in there. That. And that. I hit okay. So now during the night, all that stuff is going to get sold. And I'm going to make money. And somehow, watering my plants is about to make me run out of energy. You're starting to feel exhausted. Oh, well. Please just let me water the rest of my plants. I'm out of water. Fill it up. Plant. I'm gonna just go ahead and go to sleep. And yes. So look at that. Overnight, I made 175 monies. Not very bad. Not bad at all. So now I'm going to go back to this. I'm going to check all of my stuff. A weather report. Rain all day tomorrow. So that is when I'm going to say, yes, I don't need to water any of my plants. Fortune teller. They're very happy today. So guess what? I'm definitely going to go to the beach today. And let's check this. Oh, okay. I keep finding cool stuff, but my backpack is full. Does this sound like you? Well, Pierre's got you covered. Blah, blah, blah. Check out our affordable size 24 backpack. That is the goal. Like, you want to get that pack that he's selling, because it is just glorious to have. And then you can get the 36 pack, and you're just going to be feeling high on life because of how much money you got, or how much stuff you have. So I'm going to cut down trees, because my goal is to be able to fix that one thing over there. The bridge. I want to fix the bridge. I doubt that my guy is going to even be able to cut down enough trees without passing out to get over there, but nevertheless. I just figured out what was vibrating. It was my gamepad. It was vibrating all over the place. So yeah, I'm definitely not going to be able to cut down enough trees to get that soon. I'm going to spend the majority of my time right now watering these, because they're going to need water today, even though tomorrow it's going to rain. Now I've got to make sure that I've got enough energy to be able to make it down to the beach. Man. so lame. Alright. Alright. I'm gonna go ahead and put some sap in there just because I'm here. Get rid of some stuff in my inventory. And always be looking in these areas to see if you can't find anything like that. That's something I can forage. A dandelion. Before 5 p.m. No problem. So this is when you're gonna probably get your first fishing pole from the Mr. Willy guy. So I'm gonna just go straight to Willy. And now it's gonna do a cutscene. So I will not talk, even though they don't really talk. I guess I'm gonna just keep talking. So, ahoy there, son. Heard there was a newcomer in town. Good to finally meet ya. Ah, I'm still trying to unwind from a month out on the salty seas. It was a big haul. I sold a lot of good fish. Finally saved enough to buy me a new rod. Here, I want you to have my old fishing rod. It's important to me that the art of fishing stays alive. And hey, maybe you'll buy something from the shop once in a while. Ah, a fishing rod. You received a bamboo pole. There's a good water here in the valley. All kinds of fish. Oh yeah. My shop's back open now, so come by if you need supplies. I'll also buy anything you catch. If it smells, it sells. That's what my old pappy used to say anyway. Alright. So, now I've got a fishing pole. Boop! So, if you can get it to the very end of the green, that's a perfect cast. And, of course, bait makes fishing poles work better. I don't think this one can use bait, but, you know, I'm going to see if I can't catch anything. So, I got a hit. So, you click to keep the fish in the green. And I got a sunfish. I'm going to do this one more time. Oh, and max. I got a perfect throw. See if I can't catch another sunfish, because that'd be pretty good money to have early on. Oh, seaweed. What a waste. Boop. Try to catch one more fisherino here. Any day now. There we go, a herring. Perfect. I'm okay with that. And it's even a silver. That's good to have. So I'm gonna see if there's anything laying on the beach. Alright, nothing on the beach that I can collect. And right now I'm kind of saving my money. I'm not going to spend any more money on like parsnip seeds or anything. I am, however, going to... I got green algae. Perfect. Cool. I'm going to head on back and we're going to go ahead and probably eat the seaweed and green algae and cut down some more wood. So I'm gonna make him eat that. For some reason, he likes it. Eat that. So it gave me some energy. So now I'm gonna cut down some more trees. Stuff in my way. Okay. Try not to waste energy to get to a tree. I just want to cut the trees I already have access to. So now my guy's like about to pass out. So I'm gonna try to make it to my bed before I just drop. Because I actually have money. And with that being said, if I have money, I can actually lose some if I have to go to the doctor. Please, sleep! Okay, there we go. Alright guys, so that is Stardew Valley. I'm going to be releasing some more videos regarding this game, probably up through the first year in the game, which will actually probably be a lot of videos. So I hope this game is interesting for you guys. If you want to see more, like my video, subscribe, support the channel, and we are in school currently, me and Tessa both, so finding time to record and edit videos is kind of tough, you know, working and school. Not to bore you with the details, but we're doing our best to get you guys some cool content. So, yeah, like and subscribe. I thank you so much for watching. And as always, I will see you guys in the next video.